Welcome, Noise Complaint.
Noise Complaint. We're a high school a cappella group from West Orange. We're really grateful to be here and perform for you guys. We're so thankful that you guys have come out and spent your time to listen to us. We really just want to spread the Christmas spirit, and I hope that you can share it with us. Enjoy.
Thank you.
ransom captive Israel that mourns in lonely exile here until the Son of God appears. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel.
O come, thou day spring,
come and cheer.
Mistletoe, I wanna get to know you, yeah. This Christmas, and as we trim the tree, how much fun is gonna be together. This Christmas, by your side of me.
Caroling.
hang on the mistletoe. I wanna get to know you better. Yeah, this Christmas, and as we trim the tree, how much fun is gonna be together.
Thank you again. Will you join me in a prayer? Dear God, please be with Kids Choir as we present our Christmas musical. Still the hearts of the choir and the congregation as we are reminded of the true meaning of Christmas. In Jesus' name, amen. Now let's go see what all this hoopla is about in Bethlehem.
Thank you. animals need water. The goats need a bath. The cattle are lowing. The chickens are squawking.
And I tell you again, there's no room in the stable tonight. Now please, give Bethlehem some peace. Report. Riley?
You bet, boss. Breaking news from our zoo. Dateline, the Wall Street Journal. Sorry, sometimes I crack myself up. We just received 4 barking dogs, 3 fat hogs, 2 cooing doves, and a donkey with a very short temper.
That's it. We quit. But Nick, you and your son are my last 2 shepherds, and you have hill duty tonight. You can't quit.
Watch us. Now you won't have Nick or Nick send the kick around anymore.
Now what am I supposed to do? The only way the Bethlehem stable will survive is if we...
hire more assistants, and that's precisely my plan. Greetings, everyone. Vivian Swan, permanent CEO of the Temporary Swan Employment Agency. Our motto is, we put the I back into hire.
The I?
Yes. I do the hiring, you do the work. I was called to Bethlehem to handle an emergency.
We sure have one. With all the travelers coming for the census, this town is overcrowded and understaffed.
And that's exactly what I've been doing today, filling temporary jobs. Bellhops at the inn, waitress at the Falafel House, used dromedary salesman at the Camelot, and now there's only 1 job left. Allow me to read the notice. Wanted, 1 certain poor shepherd.
Make that 3 shepherds. We just had 2 unexpected vacancies open up.
All right. Wanted, 3 shepherds to keep watch over some sheep by night. Location, the hills above Bethlehem. Hazard pay included.
Oh, hazard pay?
Conditions can be rough. That's probably why no one has applied.
Indeed. I had to dispatch my administrative assistant, Mackenzie, to the hills. She's watching the sheep until the temps arrive.
Oh, how are things up there?
Deteriorating quickly. Her last message had only 2 words. Farewell.
We'd better find some shepherds fast. I can't take this on anymore. All the mooing, the grunting, the squawking.
Yes, those poor animals.
Animals? I'm talking about me.
Well, if I can't fill the jobs in Bethlehem, I'll just have to visit the next town over. Last call, 3 temp shepherds, going once, going twice.
Sold. We'll take the jobs, all of them.
Oh, good.
Oh, no.
And 2 are you?
We're all the Wolfton family. My name is Haywood, and this is my brother Wolfgang.
Howdy.
Speak up.
Howdy.
Wolfgang is a bit shy. This is my sister Gabby. She's not shy.
Well, butter my bonnet and call me a biscuit. I'm so tickled to meet y'all. If I was any happier, I would be twinning.
We just came to the city from the country. We're your new shepherds.
I'm sorry, Mr. Wolfton, but the positions are no longer available.
They aren't. When did this happen?
When they showed up.
Listen, Maxine, I've known this family for a long time. In fact, you could say they're my oldest repeat clients. I keep getting them jobs and they keep getting fired.
Well, it's not our fault we haven't found the right match for our talents.
And what exactly are your talents?
We're completely unique, just like everybody else. Here's our resume. Wolfgang and I are really good with animals. Gabby just wants to make the world a more attractive place.
It's true. I can make a hog's pen prettier than a glob of buttermilk and on a stub of flapjack. I was blessed with the decorating gene.
We're ready for something that lasts forever. There's something out there, just waiting for us. We're tired of being here today, gone tomorrow, of always being on the move. We're ready for something that lasts forever. And that something may be right here in Bethlehem, tonight.
Friends, but puppy shampoos and seal tricks don't exactly prepare you to shepherd a flock of sheep.
How hard can it be? They bat, they bleat, they eat, they sleep, they wake up and do it all over again.
So what do?
We make sure they stay together and do it all at the same time.
And keep their coats fluffed and curled.
Maybe you can take them to the bad shop. Sorry.
What you've described, Mr. Wilton, is not what is listed on the job description.
Sure it is. We all have copies of the ad here. It says, Wilton, certain poor shepherds. We're most definitely poor.
And we're certain we need jobs.
No. The duties of the shepherds we are looking for are very specific.
I think you better read the rest of the want ad. We need to make sure you have the necessary qualifications.
This ad was written by the shepherd you will be replacing. His name is Enoch. He's the oldest and wisest shepherd in the hills.
Why isn't he there now?
He had a mishap with one of the rams and broke his leg. He's laid up for the rest of the week. But he made me promise to only hire someone with a shepherd's heart. He's listed for requirements.
Okay, let's see what it says. Item 1, he will become a shepherd, and a shepherd always guides his sheep to higher ground and greener grass.
Item 2, a shepherd will always protect his sheep from stormy nights and those that wish them harm.
Item 3, a shepherd always loves his God, for it is written, God tends his flock like a shepherd and carries the lambs close to his heart. Thus says Isaiah. So who's this Isaiah guy? Is he another one of the shepherds on the listening board somewhere?
Not exactly. Isaiah was a prophet, which means he talked about what was going to happen in the future. There are many prophets who still talk to us today because their words were written down. One of the prophets even talks about this town.
You mean Bethlehem? What does it say?
Just read the fourth requirement and you'll find out.
Okay. Item 4. You will become a Bethlehem shepherd, and a Bethlehem shepherd is always praying and watching for the coming Messiah, which means God's chosen one. The prophet Micah said, but you, Bethlehem, out of you will come a ruler over Israel. He will shepherd his flock, and he will be their peace. Wow.
Keep reading. Enoch wrote down everything the prophet said about the Messiah. He read them so often, he said they were written on his heart.
Lamb, Messiah, there's a lot to this shepherding thing, isn't there? I don't think I'm old enough for this job.
Enoch felt the same way when he started out, but he said he liked to remember that King David was also a young shepherd. He once said that the Lord was his shepherd.
Thanks, Maxine. That helps a lot.
So, Mr. Wilton, do you and your underachieving family think you're qualified for this job?
Of course.
Heywood,
I'm not so sure we're ready for this. Maybe there's a manual we could read, like Shepherding for Dummies.
We know all we need to know. Maxine, you got yourself 3 new shepherds.
Oh, good. You're hired. Valley will get you supplies and equipment.
Staffs and rations.
Well, I packed my own equipment, a teaser comb, and my 100% cashmere wrap. The Trilogy is always prepared for life's little emergencies.
Here's a map, Haywood. We don't want you getting lost. Now you know the road that winds up at the hill and disappears over the ridge?
Of course.
Well, don't follow that road. You'll end up in the Dead Sea. You'd better take the northern path. Turn right at the second olive tree and left at the third boulder. You can't miss it.
Are you sure?
Sure, I'm sure. You know, this could be the best job you've ever had.
I certainly hope so.
Look, night's falling, so you best travel quickly.
Watch out for robbers. Don't get fleeced. Don't let them pull the wool over your eyes. You're all just mutton for punishment.
Riley!
Sorry.
Godspeed your journey. Shalom.
Are you sure you know the way, Haywood? Sure you know what to do when we get there?
Sure, I'm sure. Come on, this may be the best job we've ever had.
So deep, we head to the hills to watch the flocks of sheep. This may be the best job we've ever had.
Above our deep and dreamless sleep, we have the silent stars to keep us company. Still may be the best job we've ever had. So the most important question we can propose to our fellow Bethlehem shepherds filled with love is, what we do with these sheep? Watch them roam around. It's gonna get a little boring at our campground.
We've arrived, finally.
Look at all the stars. What a perfect night.
What a cold night. The first thing I need to do is build a fire.
No, the first thing we need to do is find all the sheep.
Listen, what was that? It's coming from underneath that blanket.
Then we have to uncover it. Come on, Wolf King. One, two, three.
Look, it's a girl.
No, it's an administrative assistant.
This must be Mackenzie. Vivian said she'll be out here watching the sheep until we arrived.
She does seem a bit anxious.
Get some water for me, Pack Wolfgang. We'll bring her around.
No. What's needed here is a little woman heart to heart. Mackenzie, snap out of it, girlfriend. Acting crazy in the spring Junebug.
Oh, you've come at last. You've come. I'm rescued. I could turn civilization people and take out and no sheep. I need a pack. Will you help me, a shepherd person?
My name's Gabby, and I think I know what's needed here. Gracious girl, looks like your hair caught on fire, and someone put it out with a brick. Now leave everything to me and my teaser comb.
Well, thank you. Ouch. Eek! Ooh.
I'll help you pack, Miss Mackenzie. How long have you been here?
An eternity. I'm not cut out for this life of extreme survival. I mean, I have an MBA.
Mackenzie, where are all the sheep?
Hard to say. I think I misplaced them sometime yesterday.
Oh, no! Gabby, we have to go find them!
Well, my beautifying job is done. Look at here in this mirror, Miss Mackenzie. I know, half of those are my signature trademark.
Bye. We'll be back as soon as we can.
Goodbye, whoever you are.
That's my brother, Haywood. He tends to take charge of things.
He must have been shepherding a long time.
No, this is his first time as a shepherd. It's the first time for all of us.
Really? I'm surprised. You all seem to know a whole lot about shepherding.
No, not really, but we're learning. A wise shepherd named Enoch told us a lot we need to remember.
Like what?
Well, like we need to be praying and watching for the coming Messiah, which means God's chosen one.
Really? Does Enoch say when this Messiah will come?
No, it's probably going to be a big surprise, but we need to keep watching. That's why I'm glad we're on top of this hill. We've got a great view from up here.
You know, Wolfgang, I think you're going to make a really good shepherd one day, and tell Gabby thanks for the hair and eye one, and I hope Haywood finds all the sheep.
Goodbye, Mackenzie.
Goodbye.
Turn right at the second olive tree and left at the third boulder.
Wolfgang, we have a crisis in the making.
What do you mean? I can see you found the sheep.
But when we counted them, one was missing.
This is Piper and Dakota, the two shepherds from the next hill. They've been helping us look.
Can't find it.
Nope, it's gone.
We're gonna be fired again.
It's not about being fired, it's about the sheep. That's what matters.
I think I see it. There's a baby lamb over there by itself.
Don't worry, I'll go get it.
Did you see that?
Did you hear that?
It's coming from the sky.
It's all around us. Oh, Wolfgang, I'm frightened.
Don't be scared, Gabby. I feel something wonderful is about to happen.
Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy.
Do not be afraid.
I bring you good news of great joy. Today in the city of David, a Savior has been born. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You'll find a baby wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger.
Thank you.
every word.
We have to hurry.
We know shortcuts to Bethlehem.
Follow us.
Welcome back, my friends.
The stable looks different.
There's much that is different. Come inside and see.
Is that exactly as the angel said?
Oh, glory to God.
Yes, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests.
We're so happy you're here.
How did you find us?
We received some very specific directions.
And knew exactly who we were looking for.
And who is that?
The angel said, today in the city of David, a Savior has been born.
Yes, the city of David, as the prophet Micah said, for out you, Bethlehem, will come a ruler over Israel. He will shepherd his flock, and he will be their peace. I'm pleased to meet you, Wolfgang. I've heard so much about you and your family.
This is Enoch, the shepherd you were replacing.
Of course, I should have recognized you.
It's pretty easy to do. I'm the one with my foot in a cast.
This is Gabby and Haywood, my sister and brother.
Thank you all for shepherding my flock. I feel they were in good hands.
We learned a lot about sheep.
And about being shepherds, Bethlehem shepherds.
And what did you learn?
We learned to watch.
And pray.
And we learned that a shepherd always loves his God, for it is written, God tends his flock like a shepherd and carries the lambs close to his heart.
Everyone, I would like you to meet the baby's mother. Her name is Mary, and this is her attendant, Joseph. They traveled to Bethlehem for the census. Our stable was so full, but when it was time for the baby to be born,
suddenly all the animals were so quiet and content.
A little peace at last. That is what this baby has brought to all of us.
Mary, Joseph, it's such an honor to meet you both. And what is the baby's name? I would like to give Jesus this lamb, for he is the shepherd I now serve.
I would like to give Jesus this wrap to keep the baby warm.
Heywood, I hope you'll keep your shepherding step and return to the hills with Piper, Dakota, and myself. For you, my son, truly have a shepherd's heart.
And Gabby and Wolfgang, I'd like you two to stay here in Bethlehem and work here at the stables. Now you all have a home.
Thank you, Enoch. We finally found something that'll last forever.
Yes, it will last forever and ever. And so, as written by Isaiah, prophet of God, unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given. He will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Jesus, Lamb of God, perfect sacrifice, born this holy night, God is here with us. Peace has come in Jesus, my shepherd, savior.
the manger really was. I watched as Jesus became a man, the good shepherd always welcoming people into the safety of his fold. Heywood eventually took over my flock and became a follower over Jesus Christ.
I journeyed to Jerusalem, where Jesus was put to death on the cross and then rose again from the tomb. He was the good shepherd, but he was also the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Because he took our sins upon himself as he died, lost sheep like you and me now can have peace with God. O holy child of Bethlehem, descend to us, we pray. Cast out our sin and enter in. Be born in us today. We hear the Christmas angels, the great glad tidings tell. O come with us, abide with us, our Lord Emmanuel.
Bye. just amazing or what? I hope all of you get lots of Christmas presents because you were amazing tonight. And you really taught us a lot about Jesus and the joy that you have. It's contagious and inspiring. And all of you who raised these amazing children, God bless you. And I pray that the Lord fills your household this Christmas and every day, that God is watching out for our little ones, protecting them, guiding them. And Merry Christmas to all of you. Thank you, Sue, for the amazing job you always do. You're amazing.
Thanks again for sharing your kids with us. We do something at Kids Choir every year. We started it a tradition when my kids were little. We count the number of Merry Christmases that we get throughout the Christmas holiday. So we've challenged your kids that when they're out and about and somebody says, thank you, they say, Merry Christmas. And every time somebody says Merry Christmas back, they count them. And then on Christmas Eve, when we sing at the 5 o'clock service, they all come and tell me how many Merry Christmases they've gotten throughout the season. Our goal is 1,000. We are currently, are you ready? We're at 225. We're close. So you guys need to help us, right? On the count of three, what do we say?
Merry Christmas!
I think that's at least 40, right? Have a Merry Christmas, everyone. Your kids will be back in the staff. Staff.